Pretty much all of us at this point know that blue light can play a role in sleep issues. Also, if you care about such things, skin damage. Good news is, you can enable a blue light filter in Windows, just like on a smartphone. It's called Night Light, and setup takes just a few minutes. Here's how to do it. The easiest way to enable Night Light in Windows is to click on the Start menu, or tap the Windows key on your keyboard. Then type in Night Light to bring up a direct link to the setting, and click on Turn On Now. I'm using Windows 10 here as the example, but it works the same in Windows 11 as well. The alternative way to do this is to bring up the Start menu, click on the gear icon for settings, then navigate to System and then Display. Under the Color section, click the toggle for Night Light. I prefer the first method of turning on Night Light since it drops you directly into the settings for the feature. It's one less click required to adjust the strength of the filter or the schedule. Speaking of those settings, they're very straightforward. You move the strength slider to increase or decrease how much blue light Windows will eliminate. As you do so, you'll see a preview of how it affects your screen's color temperature. As for scheduling, toggling it on lets you restrict the blue light filtering to specific hours. You can choose to keep it on a fixed schedule or tie it to the actual sunset and sunrise of your location. For the latter, you'll need to turn on location services. If your system has that setting off, a link to location settings will automatically appear. That's it for setup. For most people, this built-in blue light filter should do a good enough job. However, it is only on or off, so if you want more control, you can turn to a third-party app. I personally like Flux, which is a free program that lets you dial in color temperature precisely and also lets you set a rolling schedule to gradually intensify or lighten the amount of blue light filtering. Alright, so that does it for this one. If you found it helpful, give it a like, and also be sure to subscribe to the channel for more Windows tips and PC coverage. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.